All praises to Yahweh, Wa, or Ba, Hashem, Yahweh Shem. The word Wa means end, and Ba means, Ba Hashem means in the name, basically, of Yahweh Shem, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ, right? Okay, but double honors, you know, to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, alright. Shalom to the one-third Israelites, which include the Judah's children, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Indians. Indians just means native tribes, you know, are basically people of America, who are pressed together according to the book of Jeremiah 50 and 33. I have seen princes working as servants, okay, on earth, and servants upon horses. Okay, you can read it in Ecclesiastes 10 and 7. But to whom the lay pertains to adoption, the giving of the law, the promises, the glory, and the covenants, according to the book of Romans, chapter 9. Namely, the blessing according to Genesis 27 and 41, opposed to the following teachings, which according to the book of Revelation 14 and 4 represented defilement by woman, made a kingdom of everlasting life enjoy the secrets. Okay, that's what it's about, basically. Okay, we willed unto you as a blood descendant of Jacob, whose name was later changed to Israel, Yahshua, according to the book of Genesis 32 and 28. All right. And as you can see, all right, we will read the book of Tobit today, basically the next videos, if you will, all right. And of course, I will read directly from the 1611 King James Version. All right. There is no Bible and version, especially, okay, especially what is perfect, like the King James Version 1611. All right. We look up words in the English Heathen tongue in the etymology, which is a science for itself, basically. All right, and we use English words to look in English where these words come from and in which language and what so on, whatever. All right. Of course, with the correct understanding of the Bible, you can compare it to what you know already to the scriptures. So basically, etymology is important, but only if you know the scriptures and the correct doctrine. Okay. Just as I said in the intro, that's why it is basically, you know, kind of long. Okay. All right. This is beautiful, man. All right. This is some kind of script. What they show you here. Okay. But let's get into it, man. You know, not much talking. You know. Okay. Of course. You know. As it was when I read the last time books out of the Bible, you know, not a lesson at all, but just read it, you know. It was the first and the second book of Maccabees, I believe. All right, Khan. Khan means yes in the Hebrew. And, you know, I did a commentary on certain verses, but I was not talking basically about a topic, okay, so, you know, keep that in mind. All right, you will have a commentary which comes down from the elders and apostles of Great Millstone. All right, what I learned, I will put it in between the lines. All right, to the spirit. All right, not like I put something to it. Okay, because that will be punished according to the book of Revelation, if you don't know. All right, but just to add what you as an Israelite, okay, should know. Okay, this is what I'm adding not to the scriptures, but to your understanding while I'm reading this, okay? So let's get into, man. All right. Sometimes you have like, I just thought about it, you know, but let's get into it, you know, because basically the last time when I was reading about Apocrypha, I was not telling you that, so basically now I tell you, man, all right, so you will have in the 1611, all right, an so-called archaic or archaic way of speaking, okay, and if you don't know what this means, I will give you the information, okay, about it. All right. Okay, because archaic, okay, means basically just, all right, not to go too much, you know, into it, you know, it's basically too much etymology sometimes, you know, if you know what I'm talking about, but this means basically, okay, from the 10th century, okay, old-fashioned, or basically ancient, all right, or antiquated, that's what I like the most, okay, because old-fashioned, if you know the scriptures, there's really nothing old-fashioned, because what is today, it was already, okay, just think about the pyramids in Egypt, okay, why they can't build the pyramids in Egypt today when they have so-called better technology, okay, which they built back then. Okay, but, you know. But let's read it, you know, and again, if you read archaic, if you see archaic words or me talking like that, sometimes, you know, don't wonder, all right? It's an archaic language, the 1611, but it's the best version what we got. Again, all right? Verse 1. In the book of the words of Tobit, son of Tobit, the son of Ananiel, son of Adul, the son of Gabaya, of the seed of Azael, the tribe of Naphtali. I don't have the 12 tribe chart right now, real quick, okay? But guess what? I can bring it out completely. Okay. So let's see. 12 tribe chart. I don't got that in my. In my list here, man. Darling, man. Let's get it real quick, okay? 12 tribe chart. Who is Naphtali, man, okay, today? You will have it in the description box, okay? Basically. You see? They changed it on YouTube, so now you can see that, actually, when I upload on my mobile phone. And the tribe of Naphtali is Argentina to Chile, okay, and that is also proof of the because this 12 tribe chart was created by the to the prophets and the Holy Spirit, the Rakah Kodash in Hebrew, and this is a proof of the Israelite foreigners who appear like other nations but who are not other nations. And if you go to Argentina or Chile, you will have not only so-called black people there, all right, but many of them are actually Israelites, all right. Seed of Azael, of the tribe of Naphtali, all right. All Israel is not Israel. I think it's Romans, the book of Romans from Paul, okay, the apostle, chapter 11, who in the time of Nebuchadnezzar, king of the Assyrians, was led capture out of this which is at the right hand of that city which is called properly Naphtali in Galilee, about Aser. All right, Aser, you know, I talked with a brother from the GMS Germany camp last time. He basically also thinks that basically Aser or Asher is kind of like Brazil, that direction, but basically that mess, you know. So Asher, you know, Asher, you know, something about the something over there, man. All right. But of course, we're scattered, so you will have even if you have some tribes scattered in one specific country, basically at its most, of course you have them scattered all over the world globally, also, all right. But you will find them there, at least, of course, all right. So if you go there, you will find there people of the tribe of Asher, so to speak, you see. I, Tobit, have walked all the days. You know, you will not find some of the tribe of Asher, maybe if you go to, you know, okay. I, Tobit, have worked all the days of my life in the way of truth and justice, and I did many arms deeds to my brethren, Akiam in the Hebrew, and my nation, okay, who came with me, which is Israel, okay, we are our nation, okay, okay, who came with me to Nineveh, basically, because they went and you for a view into the land of the Assyrians. And when I was in mine own country, in the land of Israel, Yahshua being but young, all the tribe of Naphtali, my father, fell from the house of Jerusalem, which was chosen out of all tribes of Yahshua. Okay? You know what this means? It means Israel, Yahshua, okay? That all the tribes should sacrifice there where the temple of the habitation of the Most High was consecrated and built for all ages. Now all the tribes which together
he wanted,
and the house of my father Naphtali sacrificed unto Heber Baal. But I alone, and you will read about Baal many times, okay? Just say it like that. You know, Israelites went off, man. Even Israelites, you know. You see? But it is a main title, what you can read in the Bible. Alright? But I alone went often to Jerusalem at feasts, as it was ordained unto all the people of Yahshua by an everlasting decree. Okay, you see, so the feasts are everlasting decree, the Sabbath is everlasting decree, Salakia. The law itself, the first five books of the Bible are a decree for everlasting. If you don't know what the word everlasting means, just look it up. Okay, you know, it would be what you have to do. If the Bible talks about study to show that self-approved, you as a Bible believer at least should look up what the word forever means. And the word forever means basically that it is forever. Real quick, you know. Real quick. Just, you know. real quick, a description for you, okay? It means indeed forever, you see? Okay? But let's continue. Everlasting decree, having the first fruits, you see, and tens of increase. With that which was first shorn, and then gave I at the altar to the priest the children of Aaron, because the children of Aaron were
sanctified
for the special office, so to speak. The first tenth part of all increase I gave to the sons of Aaron, who ministered at Jerusalem. And not a tenth part I sold away and went and spent it every year at Jerusalem. And the dirt I gave unto them whom it was meet. As Deborah, my father's mother, had commanded me, because I was left an orphan by my father. Furthermore, I was come to the age of a man. I married Anna of mine own kindred, you see, and of her begat Tobias. So the scripture is telling you that you have, you know, you don't know if some woman, sexist marriage, if you sex her, you don't know if she's an Israelite or not, just by looking at her. Okay, some brothers have the gift of sermon, whatever, man. Okay, but you are allowed, and you actually, you know, it's a good tip for you to marry of your own kindred, just say like that, okay? And most likely the indicator is two, so she would be an Israelite if she appears as a so-called Negro, Latino, and Indian. But, you know, it's an indicator, you know, but... You know what I mean, okay? And when we carried away captures to Nineveh, all my brethren, Akiam, and those that were of my kindred, did eat of the bread of the Gentiles, okay? And, you know, if you look at the tribe of, what is it? the tribe of Ephraim, okay, especially Ephraim is so mixed up in these common days, okay, these last common days, you know, the last days of the last days, okay, but it's common for Ephraim to be just mixed up in the different nations, basically, okay. So Ephraim is a really big tribe also, so you will have many brothers actually thinking that they married, for example, from Ukraine or something, some woman from Ukraine or, you know, whatever, okay, and actually they married a Ephraimite woman, all right, you don't know, man, all right, but, okay, again, if you go to your kindred, it's an indicator that this woman would be would be most likely an Israelite, okay, today, okay, it's always a thing of time also, okay, with the scriptures, okay, with the you know, basically discerning the Bible, the word of truth, you know, it's written, those who can discern the word of truth in a correct way, basically, okay, and we do that because we know in which time we're in, all right, so what, not every Israelite will look like a so-called Latino in India, all right, but anyway, you are not an Israelite if you are of the two dirts and you don't get the complete new song, the correct doctrine, which and what I told you in the intro. All right, so not all Israel is Israel, so you're not an Israelite until you come back to the one dirt and the kingdom as a child, all right, with everlasting shame, basically, just say it like that, but, you know, and pain before that, but, okay, you know, not all Israel is Israel, man, all right, just swallow that, man. Swallow that deep, man. Alright. And it mostly depends on your inner man when it comes to having the truth, basically. Alright. So let's continue at 8. And the dirt I gave unto them to whom it was made, as Deborah, my father's mother, had commanded me, because I was left an orphan by my father. Furthermore, when I was come to the age of a man, I married Anna of my own kindred, and of her I begat Tobias. And when we were carried away captives to Nineveh, my brethren and those that were of my kindred did eat of the bread of the Gentiles, but I kept myself from eating, because I remembered Alahayim, which means God in hidden tongue, with all my heart, and heart means inner man in the Hebrew, so basically your mind, all right, if you don't know. And the Most High gave me grace and favor before Enemenser, so that I was his purveyor, all right. And I went into Media and left in trust with Gabriel, the brother of Gabrias, at the wages of a city of Media, 10 talents of silver. Now when Anamazer was dead, Sennacherib, his son, went in a stead whose estate was troubled, that I could not go into Media. And in the time of Anamazer, I gave many alms to my brethren Achiam, and gave my bread to the hungry, and my clothes to the naked, and if I saw any of my nation dead, or cast about the wells of Nineveh, I buried him. And if the king Sennacherib had slain any when he was come and fled from is it Judea?
Or what? In English you say like Judea, right?
I buried him privately, for in his wrath he killed many, but the bodies were not found when they were sought for the for of the king. And when one of the Ninevites went and complained of me to the king that I buried them and hid myself, understanding that I was sought for to be put to death, I withdrew myself for fear, okay? Then all my goods were forcibly taken away, neither was there anything left me, besides my wife Anna and my son Tobias. Alright, okay, and there passed not 55 days before two of his sons killed him, and they fled into the mountains of Ararat. And Sarhadonus, his son, reigned in his stead, who appointed over his father's accounts and over all his affairs. Achiraus, alright, or whatever, my brother's Arnald's son, alright, and Achiraus, entreating for me, I returned to Nineveh. Now Achiraus was cupbearer, okay, you know, looked it up, cupbearer, if you, you know, and keeper of the signet and steward and overseer of the accounts. And Zachedonus appointed him next unto him, and he was my brother's son. Okay. So let's continue in the next lesson, in the next video. Alright, Selache. Okay, and Lord willing, okay, you know, the book of Tobias, all right, it's really, for what I read or Wikipedia, all right, you know, you have Esau's messed up information there, but for what I read, okay, you know, I walked it to my remembrance also. It is not an unimportant book, man, all right, not, you know, I don't want, you know, the word important, you know, but it's not a book that is not beautiful to meditate on, you know, while we learning from the elders and apostles, okay, you know, but it's also just another book of the Bible, you know, it's not like the book of Tobit is, you know, some book that is lesser important than other books, man, no, man, oh, I don't think like that, you know, and with that, all praises to Yahweh, okay, why Yahweh Shai, double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, Shalom to the wandered Israelites, alright, you know, all the tribesmen, alright, and Lord willing, you received some edification, man, okay, Shalom.